Hi, Buttons. It's been a long time since I've been able to talk to you guys like this, you know, face to face. So, it's sad to say that this would probably be the last episode in this kind of format. I plan to have a couple more episodes out before the last week of school ends, but we'll see, we'll see. Time sure does fly when you're having fun, I guess. That being said, we still have a lot to catch you guys up on, which is why we're going to start with a long recap of March Madness, a staple intramural tradition in the walls of the KCCC.
All right, Josh DeVore here, getting ready to show y'all Central Madness. I'm taking over for JP's announcing duties because he's getting ready to ball out right now. All right, get ready. Expect madness. Let's go check it out. All right, I'm here with the teachers, getting ready to take on the bracket breakers next round. Let's see, Mr. Magallanes and me actually dominated on the retreat together. All right, but now it's time for him to lead the teachers onto victory. Do you have any pregame thoughts?
You're welcome.
Let's get it on.
Oh, we're going to win. We're going to make it look easy. You know, bracket busters, look, they're already talking poop, and they're going to go down. Look at him. He's ugly. So they're going to lose.
We're grateful that that we're allowed to participate, and we're excited about it.
We'll see if they can get the dub later. The teachers versus the bracket breakers. This is going to be one of the best games of the whole tournament. I have no idea how it's going to go. I mean, the bracket breakers showing some good D early on. Joel lines it up. Mr. Magallanes gets the rebound. Dribbles it out. Getting ready to show out his bag. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh. They got to get going.
Bang!
Oh.
Bang!
Oh. All right, 6-4. 6-4. The teacher's got to go. Teacher's got to get a move on. Uh-oh. Here it comes. Pass it. Uh-oh. Oh. The bracket breakers upset the teachers. 6-4. 6-4. The teachers are gone. First round exit.
I told you, Elite A, baby.
Come here. Let's go. You just upset the teachers. Ms. Magallanes showed some tough heart, but y'all win.
It's my team.
Y'all win.
I couldn't do it without these guys, man. They're the hardest soul of our organization to be in the Elite Eight. No one thought we could do it, but I told these guys, one possession at a time, we're going to do it. We did it, right? Why not us? We're just special to be here.
Yes, sir. Here? Any post-game word?
No.
Yeah!
Let's go!
Let's go!
All right, Kyan, warm up. Let's see some warm-ups. Get ready, warm up. Quit talking to me. Get off the cameras. Let's warm up. The franchise is getting out first round. I'm sorry. The franchise is out first round. How are you feeling? Getting ready to play your first game of Central Madness. How do we feel?
Not great.
Why?
We're going to lose.
On the left side of the bracket, we have the final Elite Eight. The Bracket Breakers versus the Niners. The Rosca versus the ICANN. I land? They don't pay me to speak right. Getting ready to, in the Sweet 16, getting ready to make their shots in the Elite Eight. The Toasters versus the Straw Hats. The Dream Team versus That's Why She Left. The franchise versus the Mexicano Mambas. Blue Room versus the Coach Carter Project. Let's see. The franchise is currently getting ready to play a freshman team. This would be a very terrible Sweet 16 loss if they get upset. The franchise showing some strong faith in their defense. All right, Christian Hernandez picks up the block. Izzy Hoffman out to the wing. Oh, oh, oh! Kyan, shoot the ball! Deep three. Bang! 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 Yes, sir! What did I tell y'all? Cristiano Hernandez, tag the basket. Lay! Oh! Oh! Flex on them! Flex on them! The franchise lost. All right, we're here getting ready to go over the Elite Eight, the final eight of Central Madness. Here we have the Bracket Breakers getting ready to face the Niners. The Bracket Breakers have looked good in all the games I've seen them. I honestly see them going all the way. We have the Rosca versus the Island. I still don't know how to pronounce that. All right, on the other side of the bracket, we got the Tonesters getting ready to take on the Dream Team. The Mambas versus Carter. Mambas just got the upset win over the Franchise with a late three by freshman Josh Fuentes. Let's see if they can keep it up against the Coach Carter Project. All right, let's get ready to tune into the Elite Eight, baby. Words coming out of Team Castillo's mouth. Back out to Tien. Running the clock. Oh! Jump ball goes to the bracket breakers. They seem to be stalling. Oh, late steal by the Niners. Everyone's on the floor. Oh, can he put it up? 2-1. Oh, no. The bracket breakers win. The bracket breakers win. Tien Castillo. Oh, mama. Yeah. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Let's go! Final four, how do you feel? You won your region. How do you feel?
I feel great, man. I feel awesome. I told everyone all week, we're fighting in the West, and we were fighting in the West. You know, said numbers, ranks don't matter in March Madness, because March is Madison, and this team right here is a part of history. You watched it.
Any post-game words?
No.
No. All right, Coach, can I get an interview? How did you feel your team pulling out the late win? You all were down early, but you came back.
Yeah, you just got to let them cook, right? And at the end of the day, that's how you play basketball.
We are here looking at the Final Four. As I called it earlier, the Bracket Breakers pulling off the tough late win versus the Elan. I still have no idea who this is, but they've made it this far, and they're looking to take on and make an upset versus the Bracket Breakers. On this side, the Dream Team, I've called it early. The name is carrying them this far, and they're taking on the Mexicano Mambas. Honestly, I like the name, but the Mambas have pulled off some lucky wins, so we'll see. I'm going to have the Dream Team versus the Bracket Breakers in the championship. Let's tune into the Final Four. The Bracket Breakers have strong comments. I got some post-game interviews from the bench players. Christian Castillo and Sergio were confident that they're winning this game. Just over 40 seconds to go. They're still down by 3. Foul. Late foul. Late foul. Solomon Benavides with another late foul call for the Bracket Breakers. 2 shots, 6-5. The team makes both. The Bracket Breakers pull off the miraculous comeback, somehow scoring 3 points with no time left. He misses the first one. They are still down by 1. Late free throw misses may cost them the game. Will the kid become the man? Off the mark. Oh! Lane violation! Javi calls it off. Javi lets the Alana Lee win. Javi lets the Alana Lee win. Wow. Get him. Get him. A late lane violation called by the refs, and Javi ignores it. What are your thoughts?
It seems the call is still being talked about. We'll send it down to California to see what's going on. But it seems that for now that Elon Plus has won the game. We'll carry on. We'll keep you updated.
They are now shooting their 6th free throw of the game with no time left.
What's it called? Whatever his name is, I forgot his name. He had a lane violation, so they're giving Tien another free throw. Actually, no, Joel's taking the free throw. It's a tech free throw. He makes this, they advance to the finals. That's what I understand. All right,
let's tune in. All alone. First one's good. First one's good. Tie game. I'd love to see what happens. The free throw's up. They win. Wow! The Bracket Breakers win! Wow! The arena is fired up! Wow! They're asking for 1 more minute. I don't know what is going on anymore. I have lost it. Wow! Bracket Breakers looking to run some clock. Still up by 1. Spin! Fake spin! Uh-oh! Out to Jay Roddy. 3! Oh! 10 seconds to go. Elana Lee down by 1. Elana Lee down by 1. 5 seconds to go. Joey lines it up. Attacks middle. Oh, missed layup. The Bracket Breakers win. Another minute has been added.
They added another minute?
Back into Joey. Joey's been the highlight of the Elana Lee. Never mind. Another easy layup. Wow. 8-7. Bracket Breakers may lose after all.
A steal! A steal! Three!
Wow. Wow. The Elon Elite win. Wow. Team Castillo on the floor. One can only imagine how bad he feels. Oh, catch this moment. TNN, Mr. Fritzy. Wow. The love between a player and a coach. Honestly, I don't know what happened. I thought y'all had it two different times, but another minute being added twice when y'all already had the win, it doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't make any sense. You know, people are going to, it's going to be controversy. You're going to see it. It's going to be on First Take tomorrow. It's going to be on the ticker. But you know, I'm so proud of this group. You know, I want to thank everyone. Albie Alvarado, Sergio Ostos, Joel Rodriguez, Jesse Garcia, Logie Bear, Coy Medina. I couldn't be proud of these guys, man.
I'm honestly proud of y'all. I did not have y'all getting this far. Y'all proved everyone wrong here. Thank you for putting on the show. What do you have to say about that? They're trusting you with the organization.
Join me in Final Fest, and I will make sure we will win our championships back next year.
They're going to get the championship next year. You heard it first. Wow. Y'all missed it, but Elijah just had some hot words. Everyone seems to be heated at the president after the bracket breakers suffer a tragedy, a loss that should not have been a loss. Elots. Mambas. Whoa, the Mambas beat the Dream Team? Wow. Elant bringing it down. After the Mambas have scored their first points of the game, they seem to be running a zone. The Mambas in a 2-3 zone. Elant trying to get in the middle. Micah. Wow, tough move. The Mambas clearly aren't listening to my coach. Oh! Wow! Three! Wow! Los Santos holding the championship trophy. You could have won this. Paul Garcia's team could have won this, but he subbed Kai Andolsky out. The bracket breakers should be holding this trophy, but no. We're watching Elon Elite and the Mambas. The Elites go back to back. Wow! Wow! In an absolute stunner. Back-to-back champs. Wow. 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 Everyone is leaving. No one cares. Wow. This might go down as the least exciting, worst championship game of Central Madness. What do you have to say about that?
I say that the reigning team won again. And man, these guys just can't seem to get beat, and it is what it is.
Wait, turn the camera around real quick. We really let these kids win. I have no words.
Gotta give a hand. Gotta give credit where credit's due. Best team won today. Best team won.
I guess this is true. We're getting ready to leave Central Madness. And wow, what a turn of events. What a Central Madness tournament this was indeed. I can't say anything good about it, but back-to-back champions, gotta give them some respect. Congratulations to the Alliance Elites. This is Josh DeVore coming to you from Central Madness, my first and last time announcing. Stay tuned for the next BNN.
In the spirit of sports and athletics, Mr. Pirro will have his last segment on the BNN in his sports corner. While we're sad to see him go, we know that he'll still keep us updated with basketball, lacrosse, and all other sports. Take it away, Mr. Pirro.
Shout out to the basketball team for doing great this season. They lost in the quarterfinals, but at least they beat Antonin. Good job, guys. Next, we got lacrosse. They started rough this season, but picked it up during district, but just fell short to making it to the state. But at least you'll beat Antonian, especially during the blackout game. Let's show them what happened in that game. Now, baseball, they slugged their way through districts, but lost first round to Bishop Lynch, just like football. Tennis, me and my boy Kyan, we made it to state, first time in 3 years. Shout out to Kyan, that was an insane run. We may or may not have lost first round, but at least your boy's going to St. Mary's, committed for tennis. Go Rattlers. Now for the big hitters, soccer. Shout out to y'all. Y'all had an amazing season. Y'all made it all the way to the finals, but lost in PKs. Shout out. That was insane season. I'm sorry about that. But finally, your team, the Central Catholic track team won state back-to-back 2 years in a row. Congratulations, y'all. Y'all won in the last event, got us the final points to put us in first place. Congrats to the whole track team. Shout out to all of y'all. I want to thank y'all so much for letting me be the host of Sports Corner. Piro's Heroes, you know. I appreciate all of y'all. I'm going to look for a recruit, you know. I got you. Thank you.
Prom season was a success, and luckily, we captured a couple creative promposals from our very own tennis state qualifier, Kai Andolsky, and a San Antonio All-Star basketball player, Joshua Devora. It got crazy, and if you don't believe me, you're about to see.
My name is Josh Devora.
My name is Kai Andolsky.
We're here at HEB getting ready to get some stuff for our promposal. We're here at HEB right now getting ready to get some stuff for our promposals.
Some flowers, some candy, you know.
Chips and salsa, you'll get the reference later. Yeah. What's the plan? Alright, the plan. Okay, the plan is to go in there and get the stuff. Then we're gonna have a rendezvous. That's the right word, right? Rendezvous. To get my promposal signed from Evangeline. And then we're gonna head over to the girl's house and hit the promposal.
Yeah.
And your plan, bro?
We're gonna go to Popeyes, and it's gonna be great.
All right, we'll be back. All right, well, just left HEB. I got the props, flowers, a bag of Tostitos, and salsa. Y'all get the reference in like 5 minutes.
Oh, you.
We're on the way to the rendezvous point, which is Evangeline's house, to pick up the sign, and from there, we'll go to my promposal. Yeah, I can't wait. I'm starving, bro. We'll just have to pop it open. All she right. won't mind, bro.
She won't probably mind. Will, but...
Are y'all gonna eat some? Are you gonna eat some? You gonna eat some?
Yes.
Okay, good, because she's not gonna mind. It's the salsa. Oh.
That was nice.
It's all kind of good. She won't mind, bro. We're good.
Yeah?
I'll
try with the salsa.
Yeah, let me get some, bro.
Mm. You want some, bro?
I want some.
Oh, that's good. That's really good.
All right, let me try it.
Oh, yeah.
This is,
All right, my turn. Let me try the salsa.
Oh, my God.
That's pretty good salsa. That is really good.
Oh, no.
Yep.
All right, we're pulling up to Evangeline's house right now. We're about to get the sign. And then from there, we'll just go straight to the promposal after that. Thank you. I see it. Looks wow. kind of good. Looks kind of good. There we go. All right. We picked up the sign now. About to head to M's. Let's get the promposal done.
Let's go.
There
yeah.
you go.
Bro, Kai, that's a stop sign, bro.
Oh. Oh. Josh, what are you doing? Josh!
Take the whole roll, bro.
Oh, no!
Josh!
Oh, no!
It's ruined. It's ruined. Kai. It's literally ruined.
Stop! Why did you stop? Kai!
There's a stop sign, bro.
Bro, what am I supposed to do now, Kai? Oh, why'd you no. slam on the brakes? You have any wipes, bro?
No, I don't.
Who doesn't have wipes in their car? What am I supposed to do about this? What am I supposed to do about this?
Why are you mad?
Yo. The main camera died. We're using the secondary camera now. As you just saw, Josh just absolutely threw all the sauce all over Kyan's car.
It's dripping into the engine, bro.
All
right, we've arrived. It's time for the promposal, but
yeah,
that little accident.
Yeah, that little accident.
We have less than half the can of salsa left.
It was a big accident, actually.
We'll see how this goes. It'll be good. All right, let's go, baby.
Oh, it's a little wet. Or no.
All right, amazing.
I don't know. I'm definitely not.
Standing in the middle of the street.
Bro, there's no traffic. It was over there, we saw him. Patiently.
Oh my God.
They're opening the door.
Oh my God.
Hi. Yes.
Hey. Okay, we had a little accident, but it's awesome.
Thank you.
Look at
for you.
Thank you. Aww.
There you go. Amazing.
Wait, let me go inside.
Rose.
We secured the prom date. She said yes. We're all good. She did not mind the salsa, but you know, that's what we get. That's why I chose her.
And she's tuning in right now.
I'm
getting her something?
Yes.
I'm getting her something like extra?
No, because then we're going to eat it.
Can I get the number two?
Number two, two piece or three piece?
The small one, the small one.
Two.
Two piece.
Spicy or mild?
Should we do spicy?
Just sweet, we'll make it easier.
Miles, miles, miles.
What's going to be the side order?
Fries.
Fries.
And for the drink?
What should we get for the drink, guys?
I don't know what she likes.
Water.
Sprite. How much longer is she going to take?
She is taking forever. I thought she lived close, too.
Still hungry.
But you already ate the salsa. I'm getting kind of hungry too.
One fry each. She won't notice. Wait, give me the breast.
All right.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Very good.
Very good.
Me and Greg are in the trunk right now of Kyan's car, hiding with the real promposal sign. Kyan's calling Alicia to come meet him right now. And she does not know either one of us are here. So she thinks Kyan's gonna be giving her some Popeyes and some, his other prom sign. She has no idea me and Greg are here. So let's see how this goes.
Kyan, can you see us from
here? Kyan, show them the cardboard sign.
So I'm gonna cramp. So the real prom sign is right here. So Kyan's gonna trick Alicia into coming to open the trunk. And we'll be here with all the prom stuff. We're hiding in the back.
Check it out, guys.
No, stay. No. Stay.
What about those? Open.
It's cold outside.
Okay, food. I look eat some of it.
Okay.
Yes or no?
Oh my god, you're gonna be joking.
Nah, bro. You don't like it?
Hold on. Vibration.
Surprise.
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 Take it.
Take it.
Grab your patties.
Okay, alright, that's perfect.
Mission success. Alicia did not find us. It was a complete surprise. Look at that cute couple over there.
Success.
It went absolutely amazing. She saw you guys like at the end, but it's okay because it was a surprise. She actually liked the cardboard sign, I feel like, more than the actual sign.
Wow, that was a lot. But there's still one thing we haven't covered yet. Prom. Now with it being our last one and all, it was bittersweet. However, we did still have a blast. Now, we're gonna show you a few of our favorite clips and videos from that very special night.
glad everyone got home safe, and my special condolences to everyone who had AP testing the following Monday. All in all, it's been a great year, everyone. I still want to put out a couple more episodes, like I said, but we'll see how that goes. For now, thank you so much for tuning in to the fifth episode of the 13th season of the Button News Network.